हेलो एवरीवन, इस लेक्चर में हम सेकंड ऑर्डर लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विथ वेरिएबल कोफिशेंट को सॉल्व करने का जो चौथा मेथड है वो डिस्कस करेंगे। मेथड इज़ कॉल्ड रिमूवल ऑफ फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव, या फिर उसको चेंज ऑफ डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल या रिडक्शन टू नॉर्मल फॉर्म भी कहते हैं। इस मेथड से इक्वेशन को सॉल्व करने के लिए लेट द गिवन इक्वेशन इज डी टू वाई बाई डी एक्स टू प्लस पी डी वाई बाई डी एक्स प्लस क्यू वाई इक्वल टू आर। सपोज दिस इज अवर गिवन इक्वेशन। टू रिमूव द फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव लेट और वी सेलेक्ट y1 इक्वल टू e पावर माइनस हाफ इंटीग्रल पी डी एक्स। दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ y1। अब y1 की वैल्यू मिलते ही हम इक्वेशन फर्स्ट का जो कंप्लीट सॉल्यूशन है वो मान लेते हैं। लेट द कंप्लीट सॉल्यूशन ऑफ इक्वेशन फर्स्ट इज y इक्वल टू वी y1। दिस इज द कंप्लीट सॉल्यूशन ऑफ इक्वेशन फर्स्ट। वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द वैल्यू ऑफ v एंड देन पुट इन इक्वेशन सेकेंड, वी गेट द कम्प्लीट सोल्यूशन। वी की वैल्यू कैलकुलेट करने के लिए, सिंस योर इक्वेशन टू इज द सोल्यूशन ऑफ इक्वेशन फर्स्ट, देयर फॉर इक्वेशन टू मस्ट सेटिस्फाई इक्वेशन फर्स्ट। सो पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ वाई डी वाई बाई डी एक्स एंड डी टू वाई बाई डी एक्स टू फ्रॉम सेकेंड इन टू फर्स्ट। इक्वेशन फर्स्ट रिड्यूस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डी टू वी बाई डी एक्स टू प्लस आई वी इक्वल टू एस। वी नीड नॉट टू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ वाई वाई वन एंड वाई टू। इंस्टेड ऑफ दिस वी कैन डायरेक्टली लर्न इक्वेशन थर्ड, इन विच इक्वेशन फर्स्ट रिड्यूस, वेयर द वैल्यू ऑफ आई एंड एस इज गिवन बाई द वैल्यू ऑफ आई इज क्यू माइनस वन बाई फोर पी स्क्वायर माइनस वन बाई टू डी पी बाई डी एक्स एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ एस इज आर बाई वाई वन। पुटिंग दिस वैल्यू ऑफ आई एंड एस इन इक्वेशन थर्ड बिकम इधर एल डी सी सी लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विथ कॉन्स्टेंट कोफिशिएंट हूज सॉल्यूशन इज वी इक्वल टू सी एफ प्लस पी आई, और समटाइम इक्वेशन थर्ड रिड्यूस in the form of homogeneous differential equation that can be solved. So let question is d2y by dx2 minus 4x dy by dx plus 4x square minus 1 multiply by y equal to minus 3 e raised to x square sine 2x. This is our given differential equation we have to solve. Clearly this equation is not homogeneous and not exact. So first we have to write the equation into standard form, that is the coefficient of d2y by dx2 must be 1, which is already given in equation first. So the equation first is already in the standard form. So comparing to the standard form, we get the value of p is minus 4x, q is 4x square minus 1, and r is minus 3 e raised to x square sine 2x. These are the value of p, q and r. We can easily verify that here the method of one part of CF is known is not applicable, because the three conditions 1 plus p plus q, 1 minus p plus q or p plus qx are not verified. So we move to next method to solve this equation, which is removal of first derivative. So as discussed in the article, to remove the first derivative, we select y1 equal to e power minus half pdx. therefore y1 equal to e power minus half integral p is minus 4x dx, and after integration we get the value of y1 equal to e power x square. So we get the value of y, and after getting the value of y, we assume or we consider the complete solution of equation first, that is the given complete solution of given equation is y equal to v y 1, that is y equal to v e raised to x square. This is the complete solution of equation first. Here we have to identify only the value of v, and putting the value of v in equation second, we get the desired solution. So how we get the value of v? Equation 2 is the solution of equation first, therefore it must satisfy equation first. So putting the value of y dy by dx and d2y by dx2 from equation second into first, equation first reduce in the form of d2v by dx2 plus iv equal to s, where the value of I is q minus 1 by 4 p square minus 1 by 2 dp by dx. Putting the values of p, q and dp by dx, we get the value of I equal to 1. And s is r by y1, so value of s we get sin 2x minus 3 sin 2x. Now putting value of I and s in equation third become d2v by dx2 plus v as I is 1 equal to s, which is linear differential equation with constant coefficient, also can be written as d square plus 1 v equal to minus 3 sin 2x. Now solution of equation third is constant coefficient equation, therefore its solution is v equal to cf plus pi, v equal to cf plus pi. To find cf, the auxiliary equation is m square plus 1 equal to 0, which gives m equal to plus minus iota. So roots are complex, and hence the CF is roots are complex with alpha is 0 and beta is 1. Therefore CF is e power alpha x, that is e power 0 x, which is 1, c1 cos beta x plus c2 sin beta x. The value of beta is 1. Now the pi of equation third is minus 3, which is constant, 1 upon d square plus 1 sin 2x. And since your qx of LDCC is a trigonometric sin cos, so pi is d square replaced by minus a square, that is minus 4. So minus 4 plus 1 is minus 3, minus 3 minus 3 cancel, and we get pi is sin 2x. And hence the solution of equation third is v equal to cf plus pi. This is the value of v. Now putting this value of v in equation, two, we get the complete solution of given equation, which is, now putting the value of v in equation two, we get the complete solution of equation first. So this is how we apply the method removal of first derivative. Next, consider this equation, differential equation, d2y by dx2 plus 1 by x power 1/3 dy by dx plus this expression y equal to 0. This is second order linear differential equation with variable coefficient. Now we can easily verify that it is not homogeneous, neither exact. So also this equation is in standard form, that is the coefficient of d2y by dx2 is 1. So comparing to the standard form, we get the value of p, q and r. Now it is easy to verify that the method of one part of CF is known is not applicable here, since the three conditions for one part of CF is not applicable here. Neither 1 plus p plus q is 0, nor 1 minus p plus q is 0, or p plus q x is 0. So method of one part of CF is known is not applicable. So to solve this equation, we move on the next method, which is removal of first derivative. So to remove the first derivative, we select y1 equal to e power minus half p dx. Now put the value of p, we get y1 equal to minus half integral dx upon x power 1/3. After integrating, we get y1 equal to e power minus 3/4 x power 2 by 3. This is the value of y1. And as we get y1, we consider the complete solution of equation first is y equal to vy1. So this is the complete solution of equation first. Now we have to identify the value of v only. And how we get the value of v? Since equation second is the complete solution of equation first, therefore it must satisfy equation first. So putting the value of y dy by dx and d2y by dx2 from second into first, equation first reduce in the form of d2v by dx2 plus iv equal to s, where the value of I is q minus 1 by 4 p square minus 1 by 2 dp by dx. So putting the value of p, q and dp by dx, we get the value of I is minus 6 by x square. Now s is r by y1, and since r is 0 for equation first, therefore s is 0. So putting these value of I and s in equation d2v by dx2 plus iv equal to s, our equation take the form d2v by dx2 minus 6 by x square v equal to 0. Obviously this is not constant coefficient equation, because the coefficient of v is variable quantity. So this equation also can be written as, after multiplying with x square, we get x square d2v by dx2 minus 6v equal to 0. And this is not a constant coefficient equation, this is homogeneous Cauchy's Euler equations. So to solve, which is homogeneous linear differential equation, so to solve, let z equal to log x, or e power z equal to x. Now this second derivative into x square, take the form dd minus 1. This is constant 6, v equal to 0. Here d stand for d by dz, because we change the independent variable of equation third. Now d square minus d minus 6 v equal to 0. So the equation third, homogeneous equation third, after using this transformation, reduce into LDECC, linear differential equation with constant coefficient. Now solution of equation 4 is v equal to CF plus PI, and since the right hand side of equation 4 is 0, therefore pi must be 0. So only CF we require. To find CF, the auxiliary equation is m square minus m minus 6 equal to 0. Now factor of this equation is m minus 3 into m plus 2, and which gives the value of m is minus 2 and 3. So the roots of auxiliary equations are real and distinct. Therefore CF is C1 e power minus 2 z, because the independent variable is z, plus C2 e power 3 z. Hence the solution of equation 4 is V equal to CF plus PI, and PI is 0. Therefore V equal to CF is the solution of equation 4. Now convert this expression as a function of x by using the transformation e power z equal to x. So the value of V is C1 e x power minus 2 plus C2 x cube. Putting the value of V in equation 2, we get the complete solution of equation first. Thank you.